So he's sitting alone, and one day somebody comes up from the back and says, "Hey, did you know that Jesus loves you? He cares for you, and he'll forgive you of anything you've ever done in your life. He loves you so much." This Iraqi guy says, I never heard that before. And he tells him again, "Jesus loves you, he cares for you, and he'll forgive you of anything he's ever done, you've ever done. He loves you so much." He says, I've never heard that ever in my life. This guy went back and sat back. This Iraqi guy doesn't even know who that was. But his testimony now is that for the next 2 weeks, that kept echoing in his head, kept echoing in his mind. Jesus loves me. He cares for me. He'll forgive me of anything I've ever done. The Lord provided he sat next to a preacher. And he tells this guy, what do you do? He says, "Oh, I'm a preacher." He says, "Oh, gosh, I got to ask you a question. This guy told me something, and it's just been going on in my mind over and over and over again. I wake up at night and it's on my mind. I go to sleep. Just before I go to sleep, it's on my mind again. I wake up, I'm having coffee or tea with my friends. It's on my mind. Jesus loves me and he forgives me of anything." He said, "But I don't know what to do about it." He said, "Oh, you just need to pray and ask God to forgive you. And he will." He says, "I'll lead you in a prayer." This guy led him in a prayer. This guy from Iraq prayed the prayer, "Jesus, come into my life, change me, forgive me." After that, he didn't even see this guy anymore. Goes back to Iraq, got discipled by some believers that are there and some folks that are missionaries in code. They call it in code. They're there as school teachers. They're there as mechanics, as construction workers, but their heart is Great Commission Christians. They love the Lord, and their main task there is to share the gospel. Got discipled by some folks that were in code. Every time he had dealings with mainland U.S., he'd come back, fly all the regular flights, buy out all of first class again, but once they got up to cruising altitude, he'd walk into the back and he'd see some people that just looked traveled. I don't know if you've ever felt traveled like that before. You just get on the plane, you can't fall asleep, you can't wake up, you're just sort of in this sort of daze thing. I took a flight from Los Angeles to Frankfurt, Germany about a year and a half ago or so, and it was 14 hours on the plane. How fun is that? I actually went to sleep for 8 hours and woke up, and I was still going to be on the plane for another 6 hours. They had a full-on meal, I mean, with forks and knives, metal forks and knives. I don't know how they do that on those planes. In fact, I still have one of those spoons. No. But they have a full meal and then a full-length movie 3 times. So as soon as you get on, they feed you, and then they got this full-length movie. Then they feed you again, full-on meal, big-on meal. And then a full-length movie again, then another meal, and then a full-on movie, and just before you get off the plane, another meal. I got off there slimmer than... No, I wish. I felt traveled. He invited people that looked traveled. "Hey, would you be my guest? Come up in first class, but I've got a short message I want to share with you." Here's this Iraqi guy doing this now. He gets them all up there and he sits them down and he says, "Hey, I never knew Jesus loved me enough to forgive me. He would forgive me of anything I ever done, but I didn't know what to do about it. Until somebody told me all you have to do is pray, ask him to come into your life and to forgive you, and he will." And that starts the joy. Scripture says, walking in the Lord, there is peace and joy in the Holy Spirit of God. And this guy says, "And I want to pray with you that you would give your life to the Lord." And he prayed with many, many folks. And one of the guys that he prayed with was a businessman that happened to be in our service and shared this story with us. And I thought, how cool is that? For you that know the Lord, you have trusted the Lord, you've given your life at one time to him. You are part of the group that is to go and share that. Jesus loves you. He cares for you. If you have never said with your heart, your life, Jesus, forgive me. Come into my life and change me. I want to lead you in a prayer. It's a simple prayer that you would simply say with your heart, Jesus, forgive me and change my life. I'd like to lead you in a prayer. Here's one of the things that Jesus did, though. And he met a lady at a well and began to talk with her about a need that she had. There is living water. He also said that he had living water that she could have. He told her that she had a need and that he could meet that need. But he wanted to see that her heart was right. And he said, go and get your husband. And she says to him, I don't have a husband. I've had 5 husbands, but I don't have a husband now. He says, you've answered truthfully, which is what God wants. Just saying the words, Jesus, forgive me, come into my life. If your heart doesn't mean it, God knows. But if you mean it this morning, you understand the message, the eternal message of the gospel of Christ, of his kingdom. And you would pray this morning, he will forgive you. And he will begin abundant and new life in you. I'm going to close now in a word of prayer. And if you have not prayed that, to give your life to the Lord, I want to ask that you do. And for those of you who have, I want you to recommit your life to him. The Bible says that unless you're adding certain things to your life out of 2 Peter chapter 1, that you may forget that he has died for your sins. Let me lead us in a prayer now. And this prayer will be basically, Jesus, forgive me, come into my life. You mean it with your heart, he will change you. He will help. He will bless you. Let's close in a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, I thank you for this time now that many years ago you led me through this same time of prayer. You knew my heart. I prayed that you would forgive me, that you would change my life. And now this morning, as there may be some here that have not received you, Father, who have not prayed for your forgiveness, I lead them now in this prayer. Lord Jesus, I ask you to forgive me. I thank you that you love me. You have known me all along. And you still love me. I ask that you forgive me and to come into my life. Help me to understand your will. And I thank you for saving me this morning. Father, also for many who are here in this worship service, life has become dull. They are Christians, but life has just been back to routine, neglecting some of the responsibilities that we need to be changing. Father, hear our heart also. Forgive us. Lead us back into your paths of righteousness, of holiness. Father, thank you again for a morning like this. At the beginning of the year, to start out fresh and new again, and for some to begin abundant and new forever, everlasting life, even today, by praying for your forgiveness for the first time. Thank you for this time, your love upon us. Lord, we believe, help us in our understanding of you. We pray in the holy name of Jesus, amen and amen. I believe my wife is going to come and share now. Is that right? This is the blessing right here.